It looks like Greece is seriously considering leaving Eurozone.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, guys. It's May 6, 2011. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcad. A German newspaper is now saying that they're receiving reports that the Greece government is going to have a meeting on Friday, and they're going to consider leaving Eurozone. It's quite amazing. This is one of the predictions I made for this year, and it looks like they're going to have some type of a meeting in Luxembourg, a secret crisis meeting. I guess it's not so secret anymore. If this happens, the Euro, the European Central Bank will be left holding the bag, because they'll have to write off a great deal of debt that isn't realistically going to be paid off. All right, U.S. payrolls grew 244,000 in April. Unemployment rate jumped to, increased to 9%. Well, like I say, you need about 100,000 new jobs just to keep up with the population growth. So these numbers aren't really spectacular, but they are growth, according to the U.S. government. Healthcare industry, they added 37,000 workers in April. The retail added 57,000 people. It's really interesting. They don't list how many of these new jobs are actually part-time jobs. Because when you look down at the average work week for all employees, it's still it remained at 34.3 hours, which is kind of interesting. You must have a lot of part-time jobs in the mix for this to happen. And I'm kind of interested in how many of these new jobs are actually full-time jobs. Because I think a lot of these full-time jobs are being cut for part-time jobs. They're just replacing the full-time people with part-time people because it's a lot cheaper to do it that way. Also, when I went to the Bureau of Labor Statistics website, I saw that in April, 2.5 million persons were marginally attached to the labor force. This is the same as it was a year earlier. Although the marginally attached for the discouraged workers in April was actually declined by 208,000 people from a year earlier. Now, here are the numbers that really matter the most to me. Civilian labor force participation. That means how many people are actually participating, because if you lose your job and you've been out of the workforce for a long period of time, then they say that, well, you're no longer unemployed, you're no longer participating in the labor force because you've been out of work for so long, or you stopped looking for work. That's basically what they say with these government numbers. The civilian labor force participation rate was only 64.2%. The employment to population ratio was only at 58.4%. That's usually in the 60s under normal conditions as in April. So it says a lot. Okay, jobless claims hit an 8-month high. Remember last week when I told you it jumped by an increase of 24,000? Well, this week, last week, initial claims for state unemployment benefits rose by 43,000 to seasonally adjusted 474,000. This is the highest since mid-August. So obviously, you see the trends going. Non-farm productivity increased by 1.6%, but in the fourth quarter, it was at 2.9%. So obviously, you're seeing a slowdown there. One out of seven Americans are now receiving food stamps. It looks like it's 14.3%. 14.3% of the population is relying on this particular safety net program. This doesn't include the other programs. We now have over 44.2 million people now receiving food stamps, according to the Department of Agriculture. This is the stuff that really matters, more than a Bin Laden distraction, more than that bogus birth certificate. Okay, Asia Trio to study dollar alternative. Now, this is a step towards removing the dollar as their world reserve currency. China, Japan, South Korea and Japan are allies, by the way, are now studying. They're going to study alternatives, and they want to study if they can use their regional currencies efficiently instead of using the U.S. dollar. That's the final nail in the dollar's coffin. They need to find an actual alternative. As soon as they figure out what the alternative is going to be, you don't need a dollar anymore. Okay, the Gun Runner scandal. The scandal in which the ATF allowed guns to be illegally transported from the U.S. to Mexico. Well, now we're learning that one of the whistleblowers, one of the ATF agents who came out and said what they were doing, Dobbins, he went undercover in Hell's Angels for about 2 years. He said his family, well, the ATF said they were going to protect his family, but they ended up ignoring his case, shoving his case, and not protecting his family. These guys, his house was actually burnt down with his family in it. Fortunately, they got out alive, but still, nobody really offered them protection. And these same people who let them out to dry are the same people who are being accused of running this Gun Runner, Project Gun Runner. And the project basically authorized, it was authorized within the upper levels of law enforcement, ATF, and, you know, now the Eric Holder, Attorney General, saying that, well, you know, he's not responsible for what happened. I mean, it's amazing how these sociopaths just respond. They don't ever take responsibility for anything. Anyway, this project allowed 1,800 guns to be illegally transported from the U.S. to Mexico. Now, they're claiming that they were going to follow the progress of these guns, just track and see how these drug cartels operated. But they didn't have jurisdiction in Mexico, so it didn't really make a lot of sense. I think they were going to say that, well, see, a lot of people are getting killed by these guns, and, you know, the guns are the problem, so we should ban certain types of guns. Because, according to Mexico, hundreds of people have been killed because of this operation. Hundreds of people have been killed. The Senate Judiciary Committee is now investigating. The Inspector General Office has now recommended punishing certain people within the ATF, but no one has been punished. It's pretty obvious what's happening here. And Eric Holder said, quote, "I am going to take great exception to what you just said. The notion that somehow or other this Justice Department is responsible for those deaths that you mentioned, that assertion is offensive." Well, the ATF falls under the Justice Department, and you are the Attorney General. The Attorney General is the guy, the top guy at the Justice Department. So you are responsible if the ATF runs a program that illegally transport guns across the border and gets people killed. Am I correct or what? You guys start spreading this information around. You want to protect your rights. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.